Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up organization and financial settings in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. The information that is required to set up the organization and financial settings section affects just about everything that you do in Xero. In the organization section, you will provide basic information such as the address, telephone number, and email address of your business. This information will appear on customer invoices, credit notes, and purchase orders that you create. In the financial settings section, you will include information like your fiscal year, business entity, for example, S-Corp, sole proprietorship, and sales tax. For more information, we have included a link below this video to our business entity guide. The information that you provide in this section is used on all financial reports, tax returns, and other financial documents. Next, we will discuss all the information that you need to gather in order to set up your business in Xero. In order to make the most of your time, it's important that you have access to key documents and other information that you will need in order to set your company up in Xero. While it's not required that you set up everything all at once, we recommend that you provide as much information as possible. This will prevent you from having to fix something later on, which will save you some time. Here is a list of some of the key documents and questions that you will need to answer as you walk through the Xero setup guide. The business name, address, email address, website, any social media links that you'd like to include, company logo, your tax ID number, business entity, your accounting method, cash or accrual, bank statements, credit card statements, your chart of accounts list, account balances, the numbering sequence for customer invoices, and copies or a list of all outstanding checks that you've written, outstanding deposits, open customer invoices, and unpaid bills. From this list, the items that are required if you are an existing business include everything on this list. However, if you are not an existing business, but you're a brand new startup, then you probably won't have a chart of accounts list or anything else below that, account balances, etc. So no need to worry about those items if you're just starting your business. Some questions that you will need to answer. What is your fiscal year? What industry does your business fall into? What payment terms do you want to offer your customers? For example, net 30 days or net 60 days. Do you need to create estimates, bids, or quotes for your customers? What payment terms do you have with suppliers? For example, net 30 days or net 60 days. Do you need to create purchase orders? Do you need to track income and expenses by location or by department? What date do you want to start using Xero to track your day-to-day business? And do you charge customers sales tax? When you first log into Xero, you reach your dashboard. The dashboard will typically give you a snapshot of important financial information, such as invoices owed to you. You will also have a section that will say bills that you need to pay. And when you set up your bank account, you will have a section that shows you the bank balances. When setting up Xero, you will spend most of your time in the settings section. So we'll go ahead and navigate to settings, and then we want to go ahead and navigate to the organization and financial settings. So we can do that by clicking on general settings here. Within the organization screen, you can edit both organization settings and the financial settings. So let's start with the organization settings first. In organization settings, you will enter basic company information that will appear on customer invoices and quotes, as well as financial reports. You can also pick and choose what information you want to appear on your customer invoices by selecting the on option here from this section. We will use a fictitious company, Acme Web Pro Plus, a digital marketing business, to demonstrate some of the concepts in this lesson. Starting with our basic information, in the first field, we have display name. This is the company name that you will see in Xero when you log in. Legal trading name. If your company name or DBA is different from your legal name, then be sure to enter your legal name in this field. The company name that you enter in this field will appear by default on all financial reports and all outgoing invoices, quotes, and other documents. If you have a company logo, you want to go ahead and upload it here. The logo will appear with your profile in the Xero Business Community. This is a community of other Xero users like yourself where you can connect to get answers to questions as well as to learn great tips on how to use Xero. In addition, this logo will appear on all outgoing invoices, quotes, and other documents. What is your line of business? You can enter a brief description of what your business does in this field. Based on previous descriptions entered, Xero will make suggestions. However, if you cannot find something that describes what you do, you can enter your own unique description. Organization type. You want to select the legal structure of your business. The options that you have to choose from are corporation, exempt organization, partnership, private foundation, S-Corp, and sole proprietor. This information will be used to complete tax returns and other financial documents. Your employer identification number belongs in this field. If you don't have an EIN, you can enter your Social Security number instead. This information will be used on tax returns and other financial documents. We have included a link below this video so that you can find out if you need an EIN. Organization description. You can enter a brief description about what your company does here. This information will appear in the Xero Business Directory. Let's go ahead and take a look at our contacts details section here. Postal or mailing address. In this field, you want to enter the address where you would like to receive customer payments and other important business correspondence. This address is also used for check remittances. Right below that, we've got our physical address. If your mailing address and your physical address are the same, then you can just select this box here. But if they are not, then you want to go ahead and enter the physical address of where your business is located in these fields here. Next, we've got our telephone number. Go ahead and enter the telephone number where customers can reach you. This information will also appear on any invoices, quotes, and other documents that you create and send to your customers. Email address. Enter your business email address where customers can email you. Website. If you have a website, enter that information in this field as well. If you don't, then you can leave it blank and come back later and add it. Down below here, we have a link that says Add Contact Field. If you click on that, you will notice that you have the option to add additional ways that you would like to be contacted. So for example, you could enter a mobile phone number, a fax number, your Skype ID, LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, and Google. All right, we are all done with organization settings. Remember, you can come back and make any changes to this information whenever you need to. Now let's talk about financial settings. Financial settings includes information that will affect your financial reports. So let's go back to our general settings section. And right below organization settings, we've got our financial settings option here. It's important to set this information up before you begin entering transactions. That way your financial reports are accurate and your sales tax is tracked and reported correctly. If you need assistance with completing this information, contact your accountant or you can click the link below to check out the Xero directory. In this directory, you will find a list of accountants and bookkeepers who are certified Xero experts. Let's begin with the financial year end here. In this field, this should indicate the last day of your fiscal year. Most businesses use a calendar year, which ends on December 31st. This is the default setting in Xero. However, if your fiscal year runs July 1st through June 30th, for example, then you would actually select June 30th as your year end in this field. Sales tax. The information in the sales tax section will be used to track and report sales tax that you collect from your customers. Starting with the tax basis field, You want to select which method, cash or accrual, you are required to use to report sales tax. If your state requires you to use the cash method, then you will report sales tax based on when you receive payment from your customer. However, if your state requires that you use the accrual method, then you will report sales tax based on when the sale is made. Be sure to check with your accountant if you are not sure which method to select. The next field is a tax ID number field. This is the same as the EIN number that we entered in the organization settings section. Tax ID display number. This is the legal name that's associated with your tax ID number. Tax period. Indicate here how often you are required to report sales taxes to your state. This generally depends on how much sales tax you collect. Most businesses must file on a monthly, quarterly, or annual basis. Tax defaults. In the tax defaults section, we need to indicate what the default tax settings are for sales and purchases. There are four options to choose from here. Based on last sale, tax inclusive, tax exclusive, or no tax. Based on last sale, when you select this option, the invoice would follow the format that your last invoice took, either tax inclusive, tax exclusive, or no tax. Tax inclusive. This option will include tax for each taxable item on sales invoices and credit notes that you create for customers. Tax exclusive. If you select this option, it will show tax separately on sales invoices and credit notes or purchase orders that you create. So for example, if you invoice a customer for products that cost $100 and you charge 8% sales tax, there will be a separate line on the invoice to show the sales tax calculation of $8. And last but not least is no tax. Select this option if you are not required to charge your customers sales tax. Once you make your selections, go ahead and save them. That wraps up the lesson on how to set up organization and financial settings in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.